endless beaches and the sea. A new age action spot, beautiful skyscapes, and a quaint French colonial town. What more could one ask for while going on a journey on one of India's most scenic highways?
We do get to see all this and more as we travel down the famous East Coast Road from Chennai to Puducherry. Welcome to Follow the Star, the show where we discover the different facets of India through journeys on highways.
Our journey through started some time back from the temple town of Vellore. We travelled on the beautiful Asian Highway 45, tasted a sweet unique to the historical town of Arcot, visited Kanchipuram, the city of the thousand temples, met some fellow travellers addicted to speed, and finally ended at the coastal metropolis of Chennai, where we met the torchbearer of Indian squash, Deepika Palekar. Today we complete the second part of our journey in Tamil Nadu. We will start from Chennai, the capital of Tamil Nadu, and also the nerve center of the eastern seaboard of India. Most of the highways in South India converge in Chennai, which is also well connected to the rest of India through the Golden Quadrilateral Highway Network. However, today we travel along the State Highway 49, better known as the East Coast Road. Our destination, the former French colonial town of Puducherry. On the way, we cover places like Dakshina Chitra Centre, the ancient port town of Mamallapuram, a hidden gem of a beach, and a beach famous for surfing. The approximate distance of today's trip will be around 160 kilometers. Most of the route is on a two-lane highway, which on an average is of very good quality. In the former French colony of Puducherry, we meet with the very talented designer and actress Aisha Kapoor. The crazy traffic Chennai is known for, I started off for Puducherry early in the morning. There are two ways of going to Puducherry from Chennai. The first is down the State Highway 66, also known as the Grand Southern Trunk Road. It's approximately 170 to 180 kilometers long. The second route is the State Highway 49 or the East Coast Road. I am choosing to go around the second route, that of the East Coast Road. It's the shorter of the two routes, though by only a marginal 20 kilometers, but most importantly, it's the most scenic of the two routes. Though, because of the ever-expanding urban sprawl of a huge city like Chennai, it takes some time before it even feels like we are on a highway and not on a city road. But even then, the four-lane highway is very well maintained and is a joy to drive on. And maybe because it was early in the morning, there wasn't even too much traffic. Post the Uthandi toll booth, which is around 24 kilometers from Chennai, the highway became a two-lane one, though the quality of the road remained good. I really like this road. It's a flat stretch, the traffic isn't much, and the condition of the road is really, really good. Just a few kilometers after the toll booth is a very interesting pit stop. It's called Dakshina Chitra and is a center of art, craft and architecture of South India. It's just around 28 kilometers south of Chennai on the East Coast Road and in my opinion is a must visit if you are traveling down this road. Spread over 10 acres overlooking the Bay of Bengal, the centre famously offers a peek into the way of living in South India. These houses have been authentically reconstructed and offer a glimpse into the past. Visitors can also buy traditional arts and crafts of South India directly from artisans. Though there are restroom facilities, there is no canteen or cafeteria at the center.
Wow, there's the sea. And that is the beauty of this East Coast Road. There are vast stretches of the highway where the sea literally runs alongside the road. And trust me, we're going to be seeing a lot more of the sea.
My first stop on the journey to Puducherry is the ancient port city of Mamallapuram. In ancient times, this port was used by traders to sail out to Southeast Asia. One of the most interesting sights is that of the rock-cut carvings of Arjuna's pennants.
In the Mahabharata, Arjuna did this mighty penance to gain the powers of the famous Pashupati Astra. That particular penance has been depicted on these rock carvings, which were carved by the Pallav dynasty around the 6th and the 7th century.
Other attractions include the Pancharathas, five structures, each carved from a single piece of rock. The most famous attraction of Mamallapuram, though, is the 8th century AD Shore Temple. It overlooks the beach and is quite impressive. The beach, though, is only good for a walk as it has dangerous undercurrents and one should not swim there. This little town also has a tradition of stone sculptures and has many places selling these sculptures, which are of various sizes. Now around 40 kilometers ahead of Mamallapuram lies a hidden gem of a beach. One has to watch out for the sign which says Oscar Beach Resorts and turn left off the highway into the lane. A kilometer or so down a bumpy road that is still being constructed lies this divine beach with a fishing village on its edge.
Beautiful beach, the sea, and there's a fishing village.
I even decided to help some fishermen in pulling their boat onto the sand.
Okay, I'm not much of a help at all. My hands are getting scraped and I don't know how they do this every day because it's really heavy to pull this boat up to the shore.
My noble intentions, however, outweighed my efforts and I very soon left them to their Herculean task, not that they even noticed.
That is the beauty of driving on highways. You can actually get off it anytime you want. And that is how I managed to find this beautiful secret spot, this hidden gem, with a brilliant beach and a fishing village. Now, these are experiences I would never get if I had to catch a flight or live in hotels or resorts.
I could have spent an entire day at that beautiful beach, but I still had a destination to reach and, more importantly, a beautiful highway to drive on. The two-lane highway was indeed a joy to drive on, with its minimal traffic and the good roads lined with large shady trees. Another fascinating sight on this journey that one must watch out for are the salt pans approximately 110 kilometers from Chennai. As one gets closer to Puducherry, the road gets more populated and one passes a series of little villages. One must go slowly and carefully because at these villages, traffic can be very unpredictable. Right before one enters the Union Territory of Puducherry, there is a toll booth which marks the end of the beautiful toll road. Kilometers before I entered the town of Puducherry, I turned off the highway and headed straight for the sea.
Now the reason why I'm heading towards the beach is because I have to meet two brothers, Juan and Samai, at their shack on Serenity Beach. Now what they do and why I'm going to meet them, that you'll find out soon enough. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what I've been looking for.
The two Spanish brothers, Juan and Samai, introduced me to the world of surfing. And I finally reach Puducherry, where I meet Aisha Kapoor, who takes me around her town and shows me some facets of Puducherry which are quite contemporary.